returning home for the first time since protests erupted in Zimbabwe. President Emmerson Mnangagwa took to Twitter to address the crisis shortly after landing in the capital, Harare. He called political leaders to come together and start a national dialogue in a bid to restore calm and order.
I invite leaders of all political parties, as well as religious and civil leaders, to set aside our differences and come together. What unites us is stronger than what could ever divide us. Let's begin a national dialogue.
Violent protests spread across the country after a government decision to more than double fuel prices on January 14th. The army and police responded with a brutal crackdown. According to Zimbabwe Human Rights NGO Forum, at least 12 people were killed and there were over 200 reported incidents of assault and torture. President Mnangagwa on Tuesday vowed to investigate security forces over their ruthless response.
Violence or misconduct by our security forces is unacceptable and a betrayal of the new Zimbabwe. Chaos and insubordination will not be tolerated. Misconduct will be investigated. If required, heads will roll.
He also criticized the protests that were marked by rioting and looting, saying violence was not the Zimbabwean way. Human rights groups say around 700 people have been arrested, including prominent pastor and activist Evan Mawari, as well as the leader of the Zimbabwe Congress of Trade Unions, the umbrella group that called the protests, Jafet Moyo. Mnangagwa had pledged a fresh start for the country when he came to power in November 2017. But events over the past week have underlined fears of a return to the violent repression of Robert Mugabe.